Clusters of stars are really useful to look at and to actually apply our new understanding of how stars form and how the distribution in terms of mass is given by the IMF, but also in terms of their main sequence lifetimes. Star clusters are essentially formed at the same time, so all stars should have a similar age, and also they're roughly at the same distance to us. This means that looking at HR diagrams of star clusters can be very useful to try to identify what's going on with them. What happens is, if we look at some of the youngest clusters, and this is an example here, such as what we call an H2 region or star forming region, those will be the ones with the youngest clusters. If you look at an HR diagram, you will essentially see almost all stars along the main sequence. You will not be able to see any white dwarfs, for example, and you will also not see any red giants over here. This is because the cluster is so young that no time has passed, and there is not enough time for even the most massive stars to evolve away from the main sequence. Of course, if we move to clusters that are just a little bit older, so instead of being like 10 million years, if they're 100 million years, like M41 that you can see here in the image, then the picture starts shifting. This is the AGI diagram of this cluster. We can still see lots of stars in the main sequence, but we're also seeing the main sequence bending, and we can already see a few red giants. This means that enough time has passed for hot stars to be gone. They have evolved away from the main sequence. Many of them went supernova and they're not even here. They've actually gone into black holes. And some stars here, perhaps class B, some of the most massive A, are evolving away from the main sequence and becoming red giants. And we'll see exactly what a red giant is. If we go to some of the oldest clusters, and some of them formed something like 10, 11, 12, even 13 billion years ago, then the AGI diagram will look even more different. Essentially, we'll still be able to see the main sequence, we'll see a bending, and this bending, if a cluster is about 10 billion years, it will correspond to stars that have main sequence lifetimes of 10 billion years. All the hot stars and the hotter stars are all gone. They all evolved away from the main sequence, and it'll be very easy to see this population of red giants essentially evolving away from the main sequence. In summary, if we look at AGI diagrams of clusters, we can actually learn a lot about how we can even figure out the age of a cluster of stars. One of the easiest ways is actually to look at where the main sequence is actually bending. If the bending is not there at all, it means the cluster is really, really young, meaning just a few million years old. If we start seeing some bending, then it's perhaps tens of million years old. And if the bending is happening for stars which are similar to the sun, then the cluster is almost as old as the universe itself. In summary, if we assume that a cluster forms at the same time given by an IMF, what we have is essentially that stars get stripped away from the main sequence. This is what leads to this bending and to the disappearance of those stars. As we've seen, it will start with the hottest stars. They will be the first to disappear from the AGI diagram or to evolve away from the main sequence. And this point of departure will work its way down as stars evolve away from the main sequence. And it's one of the crucial tools that we have in astrophysics to determine the age of a cluster.